Shortly after taking office in May this year, Australian Prime Minister Anthony Albanese promised several measures to improve the rights and conditions for New Zealanders in Australia. Hundreds of thousands of Kiwis live in Australia, but for years they've been disadvantaged when it comes to benefits, student loans and voting rights. Home Affairs Minister Claire O'Neill is promising to improve the lot for Kiwis in Australia. And she spoke to One News Australia correspondent Andrew Macfarlane.
Australia and New Zealand are often referred to as siblings, but in the past, we've seemed more like estranged relatives.
The New Zealand and Australia relationship is being tested.
But in July this year, following a change of Prime Minister, things started to thaw.
I can see what that is.
Anthony Albanese pledging to make it easier for Kiwis to become Australian citizens, with changes to be revealed on Anzac Day next year.
We don't want people to be temporary residents forever.
So with around 5 months until the deadline, we've travelled here to Parliament House in Canberra to meet with Australia's Home Affairs Minister to hear how the lives of Kiwis and Oz could be made easier. Thank you very much for agreeing to have a talk to me, Minister. I wanted to start off with the simple question. Why are Kiwis treated like second-class citizens here in Australia?
It's a really important question, and that's something that's really been bothering me for a long time, and I know bothers our Prime Minister, Anthony Albanese. And I think we have reached a real change in the tone and tenor of this relationship, and that's largely built off this really deep and genuine friendship between our two Prime Ministers. So we are having a look at the moment about what we can do to make this fairer, because the truth is that Australians in New Zealand are treated in a very different way than New Zealanders are in Australia, and it is something that the government wants to address.
New Zealanders don't get the right to vote here. They don't get access to certain welfare payments, disability payments. Mm-hmm. Housing can be a bit more difficult to access as part of the formal government system as well. Student allowances and student loans, those sort of things, are you looking to fix those? Are all of those on the table in these discussions?
Yeah. So if I can just say, that's not the full list of things. One of the things that's really interesting is that for a bunch of kind of complex legal reasons, New Zealanders can't transition to become Australian citizens in the way that migrants from other countries around the world are able to do, and we're looking to address some of the issues that you listed before, and you'll just have to wait for a little bit before we get to the details.
Surely there's some detail though. I mean, like the cost of a partner sponsoring someone for a permanent visa, that's around $8,000.
Yeah.
Is that something you're looking at reducing?
So I think the expense is a real issue, but you're just going to have to hold tight and wait for a little bit. It's not going to be a very good announcement if I announce it now. So we're looking through all of these. It is quite complex and difficult.
There are about 500,000 New Zealanders living in Australia, with criticisms the current pathway favours those who have a tertiary education and earn a higher wage. Do you think the current system is maybe discriminating against lower income people as well and kind of all walks of life?
Yeah, I mean, I think that's without question, because that is the way the system's designed. And that was a change that was agreed to by a previous Australian Prime Minister, Malcolm Turnbull. So what he basically did was create a scheme where high-income Kiwis could find a pathway to citizenship, but without addressing any of the issues for other Kiwis living in our country.
Another big sticking point between Australia and New Zealand is 501 deportees, Kiwi citizens, many of which who've lived in Australia for most of their lives, booted back to Aotearoa with no consideration of where their family is.
How does it feel to be kicked out of Australia? Our country doesn't want you. Are you excited to go home?
Claire O'Neill's predecessor copped flak for this comment.
It's taking the trash out, then we can make Australia a safer place.
Do you agree with that statement, or are you polar opposite when it comes to this?
Peter Dutton, you know, isn't known for his delicate framing of these issues. I wouldn't put it that way.
The Albanese government's promised to be more reasonable with how it enforces the policy.
So it's really clear that we will maintain the power to eject people from our country who commit crimes and are...
So the 501 policy is not going on anywhere.
So 501 is not disappearing. As in New Zealand, you have the same power and the same abilities, and it is exercised in the same way. I think what will change is how that power is exercised with relation to people who are New Zealanders living in Australia, and not with all New Zealanders living in Australia.
The Home Affairs Minister doesn't think the Anzac relationship has been permanently damaged by the policies of the past, ahead of a suite of changes expected to bring us closer.